If you like the video, please subscribe Technical PCT channel and click the bell icon to get the latest videos.
Ethyl chloride is completed. So three methods completed from alcohols, from alkanes. Next third one, from alkenes. So from alcohols completed, from alkanes completed. Next third one, from alkenes also completed. So in case of unsymmetric alkenes, so addition of hydrogen halides should follow the either monotonic of rule in the presence of peroxide and monotonic of rule. So in presence of peroxide, so this addition reaction is a free radical addition reaction. Free radical addition reaction. So what are the characteristic properties of alkenes? So alkenes undergo electrophilic addition reactions. Electrophilic addition reactions. Whereas in the presence of a peroxide, it is free radical addition reaction. Okay. Monotonic of rule, anti-monotonic of rule is also completed. So from alcohols, from alkenes complete. Next interconvertible. Next one, interconvertible or halogen exchange reaction. Halogen exchange reaction. So preparation of ethyl chloride is easy. Preparation of ethyl bromide is also easy. Preparation of ethyl iodide means alkyl iodides are difficult. Hence, to prepare alkyl iodides, we use alkyl halides. Either alkyl chloride or alkyl bromide is treated with sodium iodide or treated with potassium iodide. Treated with sodium iodide or potassium iodide. In acetone, reagent is very important. So iodides are more soluble in acetone. Iodides are more soluble in acetone. Here NaNCl, NaCl is eliminated. Here KNCl, KCl is eliminated. Or we also use BR. So chlorides and bromides treated with iodides, either sodium iodide or potassium iodide in acetone. So sodium iodide, potassium iodide means iodides are soluble in acetone. Here the product formed is alkyl iodide. Alkyl iodide. It is a halogen exchange reaction. So Cl is exchanged by I. Br is exchanged by I. So here iodides in presence of acetone, it gives iodides. Here byproduct is sodium chloride. Here byproduct is potassium bromide. Potassium bromide. So it is a halogen exchange reaction. So chlorides and bromides are converted into iodides. Example, ethyl bromide. C2HF5Br. Ethyl bromide. So C2HF5Br. It is ethyl bromide. Ethyl bromide. Ethyl bromide. So this ethyl bromide reacts with ethyl bromide treated with sodium iodide (NaR). In the presence of acetone. In the presence of acetone. So here the product formed is C2HF5I. And what is the byproduct? Sodium bromide is the byproduct. So what is the formula of acetone? It is the first ketone. So CH3CO. CO means C-double bond O. It is CH3. It is the formula of acetone. So common name is dimethyl ketone. It is methyl. It is methyl. So dimethyl ketone. Common name is dimethyl ketone. It is also called acetone. IUPAC name is total number of carbons 3. So prop. Carbon carbon contains single bond to propane. This is replaced by it is keto. So what is the suffix for keto functional group? ONE. So what is the IUPAC name of acetone? Propanone. What is the IUPAC name of acetone? Propanone. So in the presence of acetone, so chlorides and bromides are converted into iodides. So it is the named reaction. So what is the name of this reaction? It is the named reaction. So interconversion of chloride and bromide, chlorides and bromides into iodides It is a named reaction. So it is called Finkelstein reaction. It is a Finkelstein reaction. Okay, so it is the named reaction. So what is Finkelstein reaction? So interconversion of chlorides and bromides into iodides when treated with iodides in the presence of acetone or in acetone, it is called Finkelstein reaction. So it is. So in the last class, preparation of ethyl chloride from alcohols, alkanes and alkenes completed. Next two, preparation of iodides are difficult. Preparation of iodides are difficult. Hence, iodides are prepared by halogen exchange reaction. This method is called, it is the named reaction. What is the name of the reaction? So it is a Finkelstein reaction. So it is the named reaction. So what is Finkelstein reaction? It is important for PU. Next one, JE and NEET also. What is Finkelstein reaction? So exchange of either chloride and bromide by iodide in alkyl halides, alkyl chlorides and alkyl bromides. In alkyl chlorides and alkyl bromides, this halogen means Cl or Br is exchanged by iodide. So it is called Finkelstein reaction. So alkyl chlorides or alkyl bromides treated with sodium iodide or potassium iodide in acetone. So because of iodides are soluble in acetone, sodium iodide is soluble in acetone, potassium iodide is also soluble in acetone, but not sodium chloride and potassium bromide. Sodium chloride and potassium bromides are insoluble in acetone, whereas sodium iodide and potassium iodide are soluble in acetone. That is the reason. So, particular example, ethyl bromide is treated with sodium iodide or potassium iodide in acetone. Sodium iodide is dissolved in acetone. When it reacts with sodium iodide in acetone, this Br is exchanged by I. So, ethyl bromide is converted into ethyl iodide. It is easy to exchange the chloride bromide by iodide. Hence, this method is used to prepare alkyl iodide. It is halogen exchange reaction. What is the name of the reaction? Finkelstein reaction. So, in alkyl halides, chloride and bromides are exchanged by iodide. What is the name of the reaction? So, what is the name of the reaction? Finkelstein reaction. So, what is the Finkelstein reaction? Alkyl chlorides or bromides treated with sodium iodide in acetone. So, Cl and Br are exchanged by iodine. So, it is called Finkelstein reaction. Particular example, ethyl bromide treated with the sodium iodide in acetone. It is sodium bromide. Ethyl bromide is converted to ethyl iodide. It is a named reaction. Very important. Thank you, sir. Reaction. The next one, the preparation of alkyl fluorides are also difficult because of fluorine is a superhalogen reactant is very high. Hence, to prepare alkyl fluorides. To prepare alkyl fluorides, it is also named reaction. It is called Schwartz reaction. It is a Schwartz reaction. It also same. It is also named reaction. What is the name of the reaction? Schwartz reaction. So it is called Schwartz reaction. So what is a Schwartz reaction? So alkyl chlorides or bromides, treated with first one, either silver fluoride. Silver fluoride formula AgF or secondary agent or Mercurius fluoride. Mercurius fluoride formula HG2F2 or third reagent also used, that is cobalt difluoride. Carbon oxidation of cobalt is plus 3. Here we use cobalt difluoride COF2. capital C, small o. Okay, so cobalt, it is a symbol of cobalt. Cobalt difluoride, but not carbon fluoride. Carbon monoxide, CO is not carbon monoxide. Or the fourth reagent, So antimony, trifluoride. Antimony belongs to fifth group. Nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony. So what are the 58 group elements? They are also called nitrogen. First element is nitrogen. Second phosphorus. Third one is arsenic. Fourth one is antimony. Next one is the bismuth. So nitrogen forms NCl3. Phosphorus forms BCl3. Arsenic form ASCl3. Sb can form SbCl3 or with fluorine it forms SbF3. These are the good fluorinating agents. So in this reaction we can use either silver fluoride or mercurous fluoride or cobalt difluoride COF2. So it is nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, it is antimony. So antimony trifluoride, it is the fifth group trifluoride. So antimony, 58 group elements can form trihalides. Except nitrogen, other 58 group elements also can form pentahalides. Phosphorus can form pentahalide also. But PCl3 is the more stable than PCl5. So what are the fluorinating agents in Schwartz reaction? Silver fluoride. Or HG2F2, or COF2, or SbF3, this Br is exchanged by here. So here, bromide is converted into fluoride, alkyl fluoride. So exchange of halogen means Br or Cl by fluoride is called, what is the name of the reaction? It is the Schwartz reaction. So alkyl fluorides are prepared by Schwartz reaction. So what is the Schwartz reaction? Alkyl halides, alkyl chlorides or bromides treated with either AgF or HG2F2 or COF2 or SbF3. So here halogen is Cl or Br is exchanged by here. If it is exchanged by iodine, it is called Fink-Acheson reaction. It is exchanged by fluorine, it is called Schwartz reaction. It is very important. Fink-Acheson reaction and the Schwartz reactions are very important. So Fink-Acheson reaction is used in the preparation of alkyl iodide. Next one, Schwartz reaction is used in the preparation of alkyl chlorides. Okay. So take the particular example. So ethyl bromide. So ethyl bromide formula C2H5Br. So ethyl bromide. So this ethyl bromide is treated with silver fluoride, AgF. Here the product formed A. So C2H5F is formed silver fluoride, Ag plus 1, F minus 1, silver fluoride. So ethyl bromide is converted to ethyl fluoride. And what is the byproduct? Silver bromide is the byproduct. If you take ethyl chloride, so silver chloride is the byproduct. So it is the Schwartz reaction. Okay. So C2H5Br is reacts with Ki in acetone. Here the product formed is X. It is the organic compound, no byproduct. It is the organic compound. So it is the organic compound. Next, when it is treated with COF2, here the compound formed is Y. It is the organic compound. Okay? So, what are X and Y? And what is the name of the reaction? What is X? What is Y? And the second question, what is the name of the reaction? Here also. So, what is the name of the reaction? So, alkyl bromide or chloride is treated with Ki in acetone means here Br is exchanged by I. So, here the product formed is C2H5I. It is another compound. Here byproduct is not mentioned. Next one. When treated with COF2, this Br is exchanged by fluorine. So, here the product formed is C2H5R. So, X is iodoethane. Or ethyl iodide. Y is a fluoroethane or ethyl fluoride. What is the name of the reaction? The diol bromide is treated with KN acetone. Formation of ethyl iodide. What is the name of the reaction? Grosse process or Hunsicker reaction or Frankelstein reaction and the Schwarz reaction. So first one A, formation of iodide A, Frankelstein reaction. Frankelstein reaction. Next, the second one is the Schwarz reaction. What is the second reaction? Second reaction is the Schwarz reaction. So conversion of bromide or chloride into fluoride is Schwarz reaction. Conversion of chloride and bromide into iodide is Frankelstein reaction. So these are the inter halogen exchange reaction. So preparation of ethyl iodide or inter conversion of chloride bromide into iodide and the fluoride. These two are named reactions. Your reagents are very important. AgF, HgG2F2, not HgF2, or HgG2F, COF2, not COF3, SbF3. These are the reagents. In Frankelstein reaction, what is the reagent? Either Ki or NaI acetone. Because of iodide are soluble in acetone, but not chlorides and the bromides. Okay? These two are named reactions. Next, the last method, preparation of bromides. Alkyl bromides are prepared by Hunsicker reaction. Last three are named reactions. So first one is the Frankelstein reaction. Chlorides and bromides are converted into iodides. Second one is the Schwarz reaction. Chlorides and bromides are converted into fluorides. Next, third named reaction is Hunsicker reaction. Hunsicker reaction. So in this reaction, silver salt RCOOAG, silver salt is treated with bromine. So this method is used in the preparation of alkyl bromides. So by this method we can prepare alkyl bromides, but not the chlorides and iodides. Okay. So RCO is the carboxylate ion. RCOOH is the carboxylic acid. RCOOH is the carboxylic acid. So carboxylic acid, it is a monobasic acid. It is minus to RCOO minus and H plus ion. So it is called carboxylate ion. Is carboxylate ion combined with Ag plus 1. So it is called silver carboxylate ion. Silver salt of carboxylic acid. Silver salt of carboxylic acid. Treated with bromine in carbon tetrachloride. That is CCl4. Bromine is dissolved in carbon tetrachloride. So here the product formed is, here one carbon is decreases. Here the product formed is carbon dioxide gas is liberated. One bromine is split up into bromine atoms. So AgBr is the byproduct. Carbon dioxide gas is liberated. Another Br is added to alkyl bromo. So it gives alkyl bromide. And what are the byproducts? Carbon dioxide and AgBr are the byproducts. Carbon dioxide and AgBr. Okay. So take the particular example. Acetic acid. CH3, COO, H is the acetic acid. So this H plus ion is replaced. It is called acetate ion. CH3COO minus is called acetate ion. This acetate ion combined with the silver ion Ag plus. So it is called silver acetate. It is called silver acetate. We know the name of this compound. If you use sodium, it is called sodium acetate. If you use potassium, it is called potassium acetate. It is used in first year. So, sodium salt of carboxylic acid, decarboxylation, it is used in a decarboxylation reaction. Sodium salt of carboxylic acid is used in decarboxylation reaction. Next, it is also used in coal-based electrolysis. Next, this sodium acetate is also used in ionic equilibrium in the salt hydroxide. CH3COONA, What is the nature of aqueous solution of C3COONa? Acidic nature or basic nature or neutral? Basic in nature, because it is the salt of sodium acetate. Is the salt of acetic acid and the sodium hydroxide. Acetic acid and the sodium hydroxide. If base is strong, the nature of solution is basic. Here acetic acid is a weak acid. Whereas sodium hydroxide is a strong base. So it is a salt hydroxide concept. So we know this compound sodium acetate. Instead of sodium, if we use silver, it is called silver acetate. What is the name of this compound? Silver acetate. Okay, na? So it is a silver acetate. So this is silver acetate is treated with bromine. Dissolved in carbon tetrachloride CCl4. Silver acetate CH3COOAG is treated with bromine. Dissolved in carbon tetrachloride. So here the product formed is one carbon is decreased. Here carbon dioxide gas is liberated. So one carbon here the product formed contains one carbon less than the salt which is taken as a reactant. So it contains how many carbons? One and two carbon. But here alkyl bromide contains only one carbon. Next to carbon dioxide and what are the byproducts? AgBr are the byproducts. Okay. So what is the name of the reaction? Hunsdicker reaction. By so it is the named reaction Hunsdicker reaction. By this method we can prepare only bromides. Okay. So silver salt of carboxylic acid treated with bromine in carbon tetrachloride. So alkyl bromide is obtained. Here number of carbons, one carbon is decreases because of it is liberated. Carbon dioxide gas is liberated. AgBr is the byproduct. So carbon dioxide and AgBr are the byproducts. Okay. So carbon dioxide and silver bromide, AgBr are the byproducts. Take the particular example. Silver acetate. It contains how many carbons? One, two carbons. So silver acetate is treated with bromine and carbon tetrachloride. Methyl bromide. CH3 means methyl. It is methyl bromide. Carbon dioxide and AgBr are the byproducts. So by this method we can prepare only alkyl bromides. What is the name of the reaction? Hunsdicker reaction. So in this method we cannot prepare chlorine or iodine. To prepare methyl chloride, we take silver acetate is treated with chlorine and carbon tetrachloride. Methyl chloride is formed, but the yield means the product of percentage, formation of percentage of product is very less. Hence, it is not a suitable method to prepare alkyl halides. Next, so in this method we cannot prepare iodine. Example. RCOOAG silver salt of carboxylic acid when treated with iodine in carbon tetrachloride, so instead of alkyl iodide here ester is formed. RCOOR is called ester. RCOOR ester is formed. Next, carbon dioxide gas is liberated and 2 moles of silver iodide. Silver iodide is the byproduct. Silver iodide is the byproduct. So, this reaction, if you use iodine, so here ester is formed but not iodide. So, here ester is formed. Okay? So, take a particular example. CH3COOAG is treated with iodine. Is treated with iodine in carbon tetrachloride. So in this reaction, 2 moles of silver acetate is involved in this reaction. So it is CH3COOCH3. Next, the carbon dioxide gas is liberated and silver iodide is the byproduct. Common name is it is acetate. Acetate is attached with the methyl group, so it is called methyl acetate. It is called methyl acetate. Okay. So in this method, we cannot prepare iodine. If you use iodine in carbon tetrachloride instead of alkyl iodide, here ester is formed. What is the name of this ester? Methyl acetate. So IUPAC name of ester is. So IUPAC name of esters are alkyl alkanoate. It is a methyl group. It is first carbon. It is the second carbon. So IUPAC name of methyl acetate is methyl methanoate. Methyl methanoate. So IUPAC name of esters are alkyl alkanoate. Here CH3 is a methyl. It contains two carbons. So two carbons. So methyl two carbons means eight. So methyl ethanoate. Number of carbons two, one, two. So ethyl group. So ethanoate. Suffix for esters OA. For carboxylic acid OAC acid. For esters OAH. Okay. For ketones ONA. For aldehydes. For aldehydes, AN. For alcohols, OM. These are the suffixes. Okay. So by this method, Hunsaker method, we can prepare only alkyl bromides, but not iodides and chlorides. Okay. It is the Hunsaker reaction. Next, take one of conversion. So X is treated with bromine. X is treated with bromine. In carbon tetrachloride, it gives C2H5Br, CO2 and AgBr are the byproducts. CO2 and AgBr are the byproducts. Ethyl bromide is formed. What is X? What is X? Okay. So, it is a Hunsaker reaction because of bromine in carbon tetrachloride, ethyl bromide, carbon dioxide, and AgBr are byproducts. Means it is a Hunsaker reaction. In a Hunsaker reaction, one carbon is decreases alkyl bromide. So alkyl bromide has a one carbon less than so silver salt of carboxylic acid because of here one carbon is eliminated in the form of carbon dioxide. So ethyl bromide has two carbons. One carbon is removed in the form of carbon dioxide. So this silver salt of carboxylic acid contains how many carbons? 2 + 1, 3 carbons. So what is the X? CH3, it is the CH2, next COO, it is a Hunsaker reaction. In Hunsaker reaction, we take silver salt. So it is the first carbon. It is the second carbon, it is the third carbon. So it is called silver. Total number of carbons is 3. So propanoic acid. So silver propanoate. It is called silver propanoate. So silver propanoate. Silver propanoate. Okay. So because of number of carbons 3. So on treating with the bromine in carbon tetrachloride, one carbon is decreases. It is removed in the form of carbon dioxide. Ag and Br, AgBr. Another Br is attached with the CH3, CH2. So CH3, CH2, Br. Next the carbon dioxide and AgBr. So to prepare ethyl bromide, here we use silver propanoate. Here the product alkyl bromide has one carbon. Silver salt of carboxylic acid has two carbons. If alkyl bromide has two carbons, so silver salt of carboxylic acid contains three carbons. Okay, so because of one carbon is removed in the form of carbon dioxide, so here alkyl bromide contains two carbons. One carbon is removed in the form of carbon dioxide. So silver salt contains 2 + 1, 3 carbons. So with three carbons, it is called silver propanoate. So silver propanoate treated with bromine and carbon tetrachloride. It gives ethyl bromide, carbon dioxide, and silver bromide are the byproducts. What is the name of the reaction? It is Hunsaker reaction. Okay. So by this method, we cannot prepare iodine and chloride. So chlorine can form chlorides, but yield is very less. But if you use iodine, so this iodine can convert. So silver salt of carboxylic acid to ester. Okay. So methods of preparations of alkyl halides. All the methods completed. From alcohols, from alkanes, from alkenes. Next to halogen exchange reaction, Finkelstein reaction, Schwartz reaction, The next one is the Hunsrück reaction. Next one, physical properties and the chemical properties. So we can syllabus up to chemical properties. So physical properties of alkyl halides. Physical properties of alkyl halides. So all alkyl halides, methyl chloride or methyl chloride or ethyl bromide or ethyl chloride or ethyl iodine, these are lower alkyl halides. So these lower alkyl halides are in gaseous state. Lower alkyl halides are in gaseous state. Next one. So number of carbons 3 to up to 18 carbons. Up to 18 carbons they are in liquid state. They are all colorless. Colorless. Colorless liquids. So up to 18 carbons, 3 to 18 they are in liquid state. Next two, so 18 onwards means 19 carbons onwards, they are in solid state, they are colorless solids. Okay, so up to 18 liquid, lower alkyl halides are in gaseous state, 3 to 18 in liquid state, 19 onwards they are in solid state. Okay, colorless solids, colorless liquids. Generally, fluorides and chlorides are colorless. So methyl chloride is colorless. Methyl chloride is colorless. Whereas bromides and iodides, when exposed to sunlight, they are color. C2H5I. So it is light brown color. Next, iodine vapors, violet color. So ethyl chloride is colorless. But ethyl bromide and ethyl iodides are colored when exposed to sunlight or light. Otherwise, they are colorless. Up to 18 carbons, they are in liquid state colorless liquids. 19 onwards, they are in solid state. They are also colorless solids. Okay? So, it is the physical state. Next, the second one, solubility. Second one is the solubility. So, here, solubility. Here, lower alkyl halides. These are soluble in water or less soluble in water or just soluble in more soluble in solvents. These are less soluble in water. Less soluble in water. So lower alkyl halides are soluble in water due to the formation of hydrocarbons. It is slightly soluble in water, whereas more soluble in. So, non-polar or organic solvents like benzene, ether, alcohol, ROH is alcohol, RO or ether, less soluble in water, less soluble in water, but more soluble in organic solvents like benzene, alcohol, and ether. Next, mainly concentrated on boiling points. It is very important. So, what is the boiling point? Boiling point. Mainly boiling point depends on, you know, surface area and molecular weight. As the molecular weight increases, so boiling point is also increases. Okay? Here, we take methyl chloride. Next to methyl chloride. Next to methyl bromide. Next to methyl iodide, CH3I. Here, alkyl group is the same. It is a fluoride, it is a chloride, it is a bromide, it is a iodide. Okay? So, what is the correct boiling point of them? So, what is the correct boiling point of them? Methyl fluoride to methyl chloride, methyl chloride to methyl bromide, methyl bromide to methyl iodide. Alkyl group is the same. Halogen is different. It is a fluoride, it is a chloride, it is a bromide, it is iodide. So, fluorine to chlorine, chlorine to bromine, bromine to iodine, size in. So, size increases. Means the surface area increases. And here, what is the atomic weight of fluorine? 19. Chlorine atomic weight? 35.5. Bromine atomic weight? 18. Iodine atomic weight? 127. So, methyl means 12 plus 3. So, 15. Here, molecular weight is 15 plus 19. Here, molecular weight is 15 plus 35.5. Here molecular weight is 15 plus 18. Here molecular weight is 15 plus 127. As the molecular weight increases, boiling point is also increases. And as the surface area increases, boiling point increases. So what is the correct boiling point at that? Methyl chloride to methyl chloride, methyl chloride to methyl bromide, methyl bromide to methyl iodide, boiling points increases. So what is the correct boiling point at that? Methyl chloride to methyl chloride, methyl chloride to methyl bromide, methyl bromide to methyl iodide, boiling points increases because of two reasons: molecular weight increases. Second one, so surface area increases. As the surface area increases, vent wall force of attraction also increases, hence boiling points increases. So it is the correct boiling point. The next is the second concept. As the in case of polyhalogen derivatives, in case of polyhalogen derivatives, example methyl chloride. In methane, one Cl is replaced by Cl, it is methyl chloride. If two hydrogens are replaced by two chlorines, it is dichloromethane. If three hydrogens are replaced, it is trichloromethane or chloroform. If all the four hydrogens are replaced, it is called carbon tetrachloride. If as the number of halogen atoms increases, molecular weight is also increases. Here 15 plus 35.5. Here 12 plus 2, 14 plus 71. Here 12 plus 1, 13. 13 plus 3 into 35.5. Here 12 into 35.5 into 4. So as the number of halogen atoms increases, molecular weight increases. Hence, so boiling point increases. So in case of polyhalogen derivatives, as the number of halogen atoms increases, molecular weight increases, and so boiling point is also increases. These two are important. So here alkyl group is the same. Okay, halogens are different. Here these are polyhalogen derivatives. As the number of halogen atoms increases, or the atomic weight of halogen increases, boiling point. Okay, the next one. Next two. Take another example, third one. Butyl chloride. C4H9Cl. It is a butyl chloride. So, number of possible isomers for butyl chloride are 4. N-butyl chloride, first one is the N-butyl chloride. So number of possible isomers of butyl chloride. How many possibilities? 4 possibilities. First one is the N-butyl chloride. Like first combo, N-butyl chloride. N-butyl chloride. N-butyl is all the 4 carbon atoms of this state. CH3, CH2, 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 Cl. Next, the second one is considered as a secondary butyl chloride. Secondary butyl means Br is attached with the secondary carbon. CHBr, it is a CH3, it is a secondary butyl chloride. 2-bromo, butane, it is 1-2-chloro. 2-chloro-butane, it is 1-chloro-butane. Next, the third possibility. Tertiary iso is also possible. Here we take 3 N-butyl, second butyl, and tertiary butyl. N-butyl is a primary alkyl halide. It is a secondary alkyl halide. It is a tertiary alkyl halide. We compare primary, secondary, and tertiary. Okay? Iso is also primary. Hence we compare primary alkyl halide, secondary alkyl halide, tertiary alkyl halide. So tertiary butyl chloride is CH3. It is a CH3. Next it is a CH3. It is a Cl. It is tertiary butyl chloride. So what is the correct boiling point after of 1, 2, 3? These three compounds. What is the correct boiling point after? So the correct boiling point after of these three compounds are, boiling point is more for first compound. First compound to secondary butyl chloride decreases. Secondary butyl chloride to tertiary butyl chloride boiling point decreases because of boiling points depends on surface area. As the surface area increases, van der Waals force of attractions increases. Van der Waals force of attractions depends on surface area.
So here surface area is more. So n butyl chloride to secondary butyl chloride surface area decreases. Surface area decreases. Surface area decreases. Next one. So secondary butyl chloride to tertiary butyl chloride surface area further decreases. So as the surface area decreases, wet wall force of attraction decreases. Hence boiling points is also decreases. So boiling point is highest for n butyl chloride, lowest for tertiary butyl chloride, because of surface area is more for n butyl chloride. For tertiary butyl chloride, surface area is less. As the surface area decreases, so boiling points also decreases. So it is the correct boiling point under n butyl chloride, secondary butyl chloride, and tertiary butyl chloride due to more surface area. N butyl chloride has a high boiling point than secondary butyl chloride and tertiary butyl chloride. So boiling point order is very important. So as the atomic weight and size of the halogen increases, so boiling point increases. As the number of halogens increases, boiling point increases. So in case of isomeric alkyl halides, n alkyl halides having more boiling point than secondary than tertiary because of depends on surface area. So n butyl to secondary butyl, secondary butyl to tertiary butyl, surface area decreases. As the surface area decreases, boiling point decreases. So boiling point and density is also density decreases. You are going to start chemical properties. Next, melting and boiling points of halogen derivatives, dihalogen derivatives of benzene. Just it takes 5 minutes. The next one, chemical properties. Next one, chemical properties. Okay, right. Thank you.